Because I always pride myself on knowing everything about football. I was ready to meet issues of plants and trees, the second latest picture before we make an announcement. And then an hour later, there were a couple of pictures of me from that year, but an hour later, I saw a whole gallery in 1992. You know, just because that's the topic that we're here for, just tell the people what we found that year.
Oh, 1992, for me, it's special here. I played my favorite in final. It was one of us. Long story with that year, or the full coach, Louis van Gaal, United coach, and it was. Was a special person for me, but also for the team at that moment. We had a young team. It's a good place. And yeah, he managed to create a team out of those players. And we started the season, didn't start so well, but we grew the season. I think in Europe it is very well. I don't know who started, but I know one game, the last three games in the quarterfinals, semifinals. The quarterfinals was against the team in Belgium, and the semifinals was against an Italian team, Genoa, and the final was also against the Italian team, Torino. In that time, the final was played in two games, away and home. We played away, and my roommate, the young scorer, impressed the goal from 30-35 meters. Yeah. So we draw that game 2-2, and came back to Amsterdam to play the second leg. Until now, I think if I didn't have an angel on the bar of the goal, I would have lost that game. Also, I think a few minutes before the end of the day, the ball hit the bar and stayed 1-0 and 1-0.
You say you're an angel. Yes. Is that how it feels to play the final? I hear those stories a lot. You say there's always a supernatural power that you feel. At times, you don't even feel your heartbeat. Is that essential of this?
I was asked how it feels to play final. And the first round is you just play because you don't know what's happening, what's going to happen. But your third round, you know what's going to happen. You know what you paid for. So that angel was for me very important at that moment. And you're glad that you win it, but you also know that. If we didn't have an angel, but it would be, because out of those three finals, I lost one. So I'm also what is to lose the final. So for me, the angel was so important, so grateful.
But let's take it back, because that's not what you're all about. You like many guys that are all in the world, a country. I never heard of until I saw Dutch football. So just maybe there's a couple of people who don't know the Suriname is or just continent in Central to study if you have any connections to it.
Yeah, Suriname is a former Dutch colony. Became independent in 1975. I was born in 1963. I came to Holland with my parents and my sister, my younger sister in 1970. The connection with Suriname is still very strong. Actually, I hope to go there and finish the season. Because I don't know, since I'm glad that my parents always took us. So the connection stays, and it's roots, say where your master strength. What is that? As a child, you have a.
Yeah.
Where is when it's valid, that's what you are, and where you're from.
Yeah.
So I lived for 46 years in Holland, and enjoyed my Holland, but soon I was still in my home. So,
okay. And you start football when? Was it a natural thing? You tried basketball or anything else before that?
Oh, when I came from Suriname to Holland, I was 6 years old. I never played soccer or football in Suriname. I think after 2 days in Holland, I started playing football in the street. So it was.
Is kids soccer?
Yeah.
You know, in South Africa, when a South African player was in Europe, the story always goes from the best is kids soccer. So that you can relate it, said, you know, someone from Holland to say, but we imagine everything's organized. It's probably a court.
That's been organized more and more, but I know when I played on the street, we had the poles of the labs. Say what?
Yeah.
Yeah, two, we played there. Yeah. That's for a little pole. We had bricks for our goals or our keys.
Yeah.
So we had to improvise a little bit. So. But it was natural. That I can space enough to play. Nowadays, there's a lot of cars and houses built, so the space is going away. But I think one of the important things of development for soccer is playing this football on the street. You go there to your parents, it's not a nice pitch like here. You make your own rules, but also respect them. Don't have reference to play football, so the basics of football is
sure. And you obviously start to organize football, etc. But then you get spotted at some stage when you join the Giants that you know you play outside.
Yeah, I played at school, after school, sorry, and on the streets. I started playing after a year. There was a moment that another team Ajax League. When I think back, I'm back to Ajax, Dog Ajax. And in 1995, certainly both came to Ajax. And he was in the Boston and said, what should be told? That we start to play the first team of a long time. And maybe a good opportunity for me. But to become actually the right time.
Okay, before we go to the city of life, the really unhappy relationship. Let's just take it back to you. I know you coach very young guys here. You coach young guys before. You know, what is 17 in his first paycheck? As a professional.
At school, I had a friend, school friend, and his brother had a BMW. I said, when I got my first contract, I bought a car. Not noticing that there was still tax to be paid out of it. So, I don't know actually what I did with my first paycheck. I think one thing I admire. But a big respect to my parents, but it must be that I bought them something out of my first career paycheck. Because my parents are very young. So.
Not many people call him out based on their parents. He has infected people in an amazing way. And it's quite a story. You are the first super human in the world. Yes, now it's a normal thing. Distribution, working mass, working today. How is the concept developed? Was it a natural thing? You come to do the concept and say, this is what I want to do, thank you, or as a really natural thing. That's what you are doing.
Well, the way you want to play was very offensive. High pressure means that you leave a lot of space in the back of the defense. And you need the player, this is what I said, you need the player to cover that space. Actually, I'm watching it now. You didn't want to play the ball. You land on pizza players. But it was needed. So you need the goalkeeper to do this. To train his hands, but also the feet. Never simply do what it is like to go to. Just watch how the players react on me or on the other people. And so that the most important thing is react positive to me. Because, as I said, speed is very important. I could play because I learned to play football with speed, but I also could play with my hands. So it was a natural. And process and gave you a chance, gave you a lot of confidence in that, and because of him, I became a goalkeeper who was more or less the first one who could play as a super. Not forced, but I could play because the team played like that, or the team played like that. So it was for me, and that's what.
How was this? Because besides all the things that we read about, we hear Sir Alistair seems to throw things against the wall. You know, I've seen you stop players, shout at the players. How was your temperament as a
coach? Oh, he was, I think he was less temperament than I am. For sure, but if you said something, then you start thinking, then you say, shit. But for someone who's thinking of one step, not two steps, but five, 10 steps in advance. And because of that, you also, as a player, start thinking like that. So, our way of playing, our way of thinking was maybe advanced, but was always one, two steps ahead. So, and that's possibly done in Conway's way. That's why I try to go 3 years, we're always one step behind. So I think that's the whole journey, but it's always one step, 2 steps ahead. And if you see this final today, you will see it upstairs. This thing is good. Don't play us, learn them to think one step ahead. The most amazing person as a coach, also as a person,
immediately after that, we go back to Goldman.
Was first for Leo Bainer. Leo Bainer for the assistant coach of Brown as well.
And that's the guy who won the Goldman trophy at the time, and now the Goldman. His style of coaching is very unfair.
If you watch me, I'm more he was very temperament.
Yeah.
also very precise. Discipline. Actually, he is a teacher.
Okay.
And you can see that in his whole way of coaching.
Yeah.
In the beginning, he was very teaching was more. His greatest coach was more teaching than coaching. That's okay with your players. But I think after he left Ajax and went to Barcelona, forgot that sometimes you also have to coach. Young players like Adetka and Fabavis, Sador, all of those young players, they had to be taught.
But I don't want to go on national TV.
But now you're teaching me something. but when you go to Barcelona with all the players, you have to, it's more coaching than teaching. So there's very, very different things as a coach. You have to know when to teach, when you have to coach. Teaching is stopping. Coaching is give them time, put them in the final, in the environment where they can learn, that they can show their stuff. Of course, it's not always if you teach someone something, you will learn it. Sometimes it has to be in the environment where he sees and sees himself or others.
Is that why he struggles with superstar types?
In the beginning, yes, but now it's a piece of the you also learn that you have to work in that concentration.
Before I open the floor to the people, as a tradition, you know, if you can maybe take us through, I mean, you know Peter Bosz, the coach of Ajax right now. Now we've spoken about two player coaches, and him restarting the legacy that maybe have sort of come short. I don't want to say fair, but have come short. He's had a passion, it's been a while. How is this? Are you surprised? Are you surprised that they come as well?
I'm not surprised the way they play it. Because I don't think I've taken them on the national team under 20, I believe. He was my coach in my last year as a player. I played in the MG team. He was my coach. So I know he's very big. I saw him coaching my teams. And it's very, aggressive forward. And you can see back now, it's pressing forward, very offensive. And of course, he was coach of Heracles, because there was a lot of teams, but less pressure on Ajax.
Yeah.
But if you see Ajax play now, it's not only his work, also Frank de Boer. Something in this team, all the people work on it, but he's doing a great job. I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised. But it's not actually good. If you look at the semifinals, the quarterfinals, it's not, but the way they are playing, especially at home,
all the ones that we gave from them about, I mean, everybody's going on about the average age of IELTS, which is probably the aim anyway. IELTS always have 19 young stars. Is this, have you guys engaged on how awesome or how proud everybody is of that achievement?
Yeah, it's a moment in IELTS. All the IELTS teams, and you can see it also here. Philosophy of the basics is to make young players help them the way they anticipate. And that's what they are doing at this moment. And the group of old players, both master and son, they try to keep the philosophy going right. By using double players. You can't only play with double players, but that's a question. Yeah. You get this team now, life is 7 years old. The league is 7 years old. They were in the team. A lot of players are young. Then you say, very quick, that they are not experienced. But we need 500. Games with experience. I know players who played 10 years in the high school, but for me they are still not experienced. Because experience means that you know how to solve problems when they are there, how to deal with things. It's not always age dependent.
Now, I don't know if you touched on the psyche of the ambition, what's going on inside now. Perhaps you can share this. Is anybody nervous? Is anybody more excited than nervous? Is anybody confident that something special can be achieved?
I don't know. What I just said before, none of those players have played the final before, so they don't know what's going to happen in the minute. Only will notice it when they win it. But they are eager to learn history. And that you can see a lot of things in their way of professionalism,
yeah.
The way of playing, the way of how they live. So they know that they can write history. What will happen if they want them or lose, they don't know. At this moment in Amsterdam, I saw the videos, it's crazy. It's
yeah.
After 20 years, I think.
Yeah.
It's in the final event, so all Amsterdam is red and white. People are against it, or street and all those things. So, but then you don't know.
Yeah.
Until you win it and see afterwards what's happening. And then you don't know for next time. So,
yeah, got it. Right.
I don't want to be the only one with the
privilege. Yeah, man, yeah. All right, guys, just to remind you, by the way, that I can see that your phone.
That's my phone.
That's your phone.
It's a fine phone. Soon I'll lose it.
It's a ringtone, coach. With a ringtone. All right, guys, just remember that, by the way, you can charge your batteries out of it, where you can also get internet access, free internet access. So please, just if your battery's on 50%, 40%, you can go charge them and find a bit more information about the brand, what they do, and how you guys can get your access right here, right now. All right. You want to start with the question about now, or do you have a question, Roger?
Sorry, what was it?
Yes.
I forgot to motivate people.
Motivate? You're going to motivate them with alcohol? Is this a Kipton problem? No wonder they had it to let's go.
You know, it's very untraditional to offer
yes,
a prize at Disney Nights. But we won't offer only one.
Huh?
But we offer two.
Yeah, but they didn't know that.
Oh, they didn't know?
No.
Oh.
Why have we three bottles?
I don't know. We stopped at two. So, this is our new sponsor, Glenbrick Cinnamon Whiskey. And they've been generous enough to offer us two bottles. Not for us to drink, but to share with you. So, to spread the love. So, your good question. We'll earn you a party to take home tonight.
I said, who's gonna adjudicate that? Is the coach gonna adjudicate that?
Yeah, I think let's give this kid the coach.
Fantastic. All right.
He said he's more like Macau, so he likes being in charge.
He likes, and don't give your friend that so you can vote for the coach. I've seen it happen before.
But I will ask that question. Right.
What is your vision for ICF now?
My vision? We have to make clear this ICF now, where do you stand, where do you want to go, and how you want to achieve that. And I think we have the same edge, only another city, different cities. If one compares one by one with ICF, that's we have a relationship. So also my vision of my statement is to try to achieve the same things we do in Amsterdam. And that's the philosophy by the film in the ground plays, in the way of playing, in the way of behaving and attitude, and how we have been, it's not arrogant about it, but being proud to be what we are, and to start playing in that way, to play in the first team, and to play overseas. That's my vision concerning my school job. I think that's the way we have to think.
All right, so there we go.
Hello, coach.
Good
evening. I'm Victor. My name is Victor.